Hi 10th, welcome back to my channel. Today I came with a very important question. This is important for your board exam. Read this question. If tan A is equal to n tan B and sin A is equal to m sin B, then prove that, you should prove that cos square A is equal to m square minus 1 divided by n square minus 1. Let me repeat the question. If tan A is equal to n tan B and sin A is equal to m sin B, we are supposed to prove that cos square A is equal to m square minus 1 divided by n square minus 1. Let me try to prove this question. So what are the given things? It is given that tan A is equal to n tan B. Can I write it as tan A is equal to n as it is? Instead of tan B, can I replace it as 1 by cot B? Because we know that tan is the inverse of cot. So tan B I can easily replace as 1 by cot B, no? So from this equation, and you know, the next thing is given as sin A is equal to m sin B, no? Okay, so this equation let me replace as sin A is equal to m into, sin is the inverse of cosec. So sin B is the inverse of cosec B. So can I write sin B as 1 by cosec B? Of course. So from this expression, I'm going to derive this. This is your first expression and this is your second expression. And these two expressions came from the two given things. You may understood, no? From this expression, can you derive an expression for cot B? Of course. How you can make an expression for cot B? Cot B you just take to left side. Since it is in the denominator, when you take to left side, it becomes here cot B. And right side, n will remain into 1 will remain as it is. When you take this tan A to right side, it becomes in the denominator part. You may understood, no? Cot B to left side, since it is in the denominator part, when you take to left side, it becomes here in like this. Then n into 1 as it is. When you take this tan A to right side, it becomes in the denominator. I think it is clear almost, no? Yes. And here similarly, can you derive an expression for cosec B? Cosec B just take to left side and right side m into 1 will remain. Then sin A to right side, it becomes in the denominator part 1 by like this, no? Okay. And there exists an identity. We have discussed that identity several times. That identity says that. So before going to that, let me recall, this is the given thing, from that we have derived this expression, and this is the next thing which is given, from that we have derived this expression. So we in with us now two expressions are there with us. Okay, and there exists an identity. Can you tell me that identity? Which is that identity? Connecting between cot and cosec. There is an identity connecting between cot and cosec. Which is that identity? 1 plus, the identity is 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. Otherwise, we can say that cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. So, we are going to use that identity cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. Otherwise, in terms of B, cosec square B minus cot square B is equal to 1. This is the identity I am going to use here. This identity came from the identity 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. This is the identity. And what is cosec B? This is cosec B. What is that? M by sin A. So cosec square will be M square by sin square B minus cot B. It is given as N by tan A. See, we have calculated cot B as N by tan A. So cot square B will be M N square by tan square A is equal to 1. Solve this expression, we will get the proof. We will get, finally we will reach here. Cos square is equal to M square minus 1 divided by N square minus 1. Let me try to help you. So this much is clear now almost. And by the next step, what we can do is m square by sin square A as it is minus n square by tan square A. Can you replace as sin square A by cos square A? Of course. This tan square A replaces as sin square A by cos square A, right side is 1. This much is clear now almost. So we have reached this much. And you know that here we can take the reciprocal and multiply. When you so it becomes n square divided by sin square A by cos square A. When you take the reciprocal and multiply, it becomes like this, n square into cos square A by sin square A. That means this cos square A will join with this numerator. You just try by taking the reciprocal and multiplication. You just do that process, this cos square A will join with the numerator. So what will remain? M square A by sin square A minus n square cos square A by sin square A is equal to 1. You may understood, no? And now just see, the denominator is same. So just write the denominator and subtract the numerator. Because this is a fraction, this is a fraction, both fractions denominator is same. So the numerator will be m square minus n square cos square is equal to 1, no? Any problem? Okay. So it becomes, when you take the sine square at right side, it becomes m square minus n square cos square a. Just take this sine square at right side, it becomes 1 into sine square a is sine square a. And the very next step, what we can do is m square minus n square cos square a is equal to sine square a. Can you replace as 1 minus cos square a? Okay, so you can ask me why we are replacing like that, because we need the proof in terms of cos square a. That's why I made this kind of change. Okay, now we just see this one, you just take the left side, so it becomes, you just maintain m square in the left side, take this one to left side, it becomes minus 1, and take this minus n square cos square a to right side, it becomes plus n square cos square a, and right side what will remain? Minus cos square a will remain. So we made few changes, like we have take this one to left side by keeping m square in the left side, okay, and this minus n square at right side, plus n square a, and minus cos square a as it is in the right side. Okay, now we just see left side is m square minus 1, and from the right side let us take cos square a outside, so what will remain? N square minus 1. Okay, now we just see cos square a, you just maintain the left right side, and left side is m square minus 1, take this n square minus 1 to left side, it become minus n, sorry, by n square minus 1, so cos square a will be m square minus 1 divided by n square minus 1. This is the thing we have to prove. So you may understood this proof. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and share the videos to your friends. Okay, thank you.